Tonight on Sports Page, Game 3 of the Stanley Cup Final, every bit as good as Game 2, but with a different result. Jim Sandusky turns down the NFL. The receiver remains the BC line. Chris Hebb has a feature on the Canadian team taking part in the World Cup of Rugby. And Canada's World Cup soccer coach gives his views on the new Canadian Soccer League. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Sports Page. As the Edmonton Oilers blow a three-goal lead and what would surely have been an insurmountable three-game lead in tonight's third game of the Stanley Cup Final, trailing the Oilers 2-0 and staring up at a 3-0 second period deficit, even the most diehard Philadelphia fan could have excused himself if he thought he heard the fat lady begin to sing. But as Yogi once intoned, it ain't over till it's over. And indeed, from what looked like certain doom, the Flyers jumped out of the grave to score 5 straight unanswered goals, sending the spectrum throng into a frenzy as Philly beats Edmonton 5-3 to cut the Oilers' lead in the series to 1. Early in the first period, Oilers press Hextall out of position, but there to make the save off Nielsen is defenseman Brad Marsh as he gets the mitt on it, and later he would clear away a loose puck. Later, the Oilers do capitalize, shorthanded Craig McTavish to Messier, and Gaétan Boucher would have a tough time catching that guy. His 11th of the playoffs, 1-0 Edmonton, and the Oilers look to be on their way, holding the lead and getting goaltending like this from Grant Fuhr, back-to-back saves off Ron Sutter, and then Scott Mellenby. And then with 9 seconds left in the opening frame, the Oilers go up by 2. Watch the save Hextall makes here, batting the puck away before it goes over the goal line. At that point, the Flyer defense freezes. That allows Paul Coffey to move into the slot. Gretzky the pass. The Oilers led 2-0 after 1. Early in the second, the Oilers get lucky. Anderson moves in alone. Fans on his deke attempt, but manages to slip the puck between Hextall's legs. 3-0, but the Flyers get a lucky one of their own on the power play. Rick Tocchet, the pass to Craven. The puck will go in off the shaft of Craven's stick. Flyers on the way back, 3-1. The Flyer comeback continues with another power play goal. Peter Zezel will get the puck at the side, centers it, and it goes in off the stick of Craig Muni. It was in by that much, according to referee Ron Koharski. Flyers within 1-3-2. The Flyers tie the game 4 minutes into the third. Scott Mellenby on the right side. He unloads one that Fuhr can't handle. Mellenby's 5th 3-all. Then there's 17 seconds later. Sutter to Howe. Howe, the pinpoint pass to Brad McCrimmon, and suddenly the Flyers had a miracle 4-3 lead. And in case you're wondering, folks, yes, they do serve beer in the stands at the Spectrum. That's what I call a large support. Later, the Oilers look to draw. Even Glenn Anderson will scoot around Howe, but there with the enormous save is Ronnie Hextall. He would look at 28 shots in the night. Finally, the Oilers pull Fuhr in the last minute, and it backfires. Prop with the puck at center. He hits the yawning cage, and the Flyers score a come-from-behind 5-3 win over the Edmonton Oilers. They now trail the best of 7-2-1. Once again, the final 5-3. Flyers over Edmonton. So the Flyers, after surrendering a shorthanded and a late goal in the opening frame, then allowing a fluky 3-0 goal, their spirit, you would have thought, should have been broken. But Philadelphia shows tremendous character. Against all odds, they battle back for a 5-3 victory, a dramatic shift or swing of momentum, to say the least. Said Glenn Sather afterwards, "We weren't very smart. We were not very patient. And it cost us a hockey game. We were our own worst enemy tonight." Oilers defenseman Kevin Lowe echoed those sentiments, saying, "We lost because we broke down and lacked discipline. It was probably our worst game discipline-wise in the playoffs." The Oilers will have a chance to regain the momentum in the series on Sunday. A 4 o'clock in the afternoon start Pacific time, and you can see the game right here on VU 13.